Tule mateke.
Asanjo di kupe udilo. 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 Mapenzi ya geto indio. Udilo. Udilo. Udilo.
Joni kupe udilo. 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 Joni kupe kupe udilo. Udilo. Udilo.
Hoya, mama, unani tuliza. Niki yangu kunani uko. Kumbusha hata iwe nini utanipenda.
Boy, I'm nothing without you. Baby, I can do anything good without you. Baby,
kana omni kuteke nyesi atu pekeje.
Namadui tule mateke.
Kana omni kuteke nyesi atu pekeje.
Namadui tule mateke.
Asanjo di kupe udilo. Udilo. Udilo.
And that was a beautiful dance. There goes the flower. Thank you very much for tuning on to Beyond Limits. How are you? I hope you are well with all your loved ones. The world is such a beautiful canvas with splashes and strips of different colors of paints. And each and every one of us brings a different color to this beautiful canvas. Here on Beyond Limits, we actually hang out and have conversations with the boldest and the most conspicuous of these colors. And tonight, we have none other than, if you know her, you definitely know her as Miss Trudy. Hi, darling.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
You look amazing. Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much for having me.
It is good to have you here today. And one of the things that I'm actually looking at right now happening in the world is young girls looking at different ways of just becoming really financially empowered. Mm-hmm. Like every girl wants to have her own chums. Is this where you're heading to?
Yeah.
How
the world
does it
is
feel?
Changing. Oh, it feels so good.
Thank you for coming. You're actually Gertrude Zuma. How did the name Miss Trudy come about from this?
Trudy is a short form of Gertrude.
Oh, yeah?
So, yeah, Trudy is my nickname, basically. Mm-hmm. So I just added a Miss in front and came up with Miss Trudy.
And here comes the fun and sassy name that she actually holds. If you want to check her out right now, you can actually go to YouTube and key in Miss Trudy, and you're going to realize there's tons and tons of videos that you need to watch about traveling. Traveling vlog. This is what we're calling it, right?
Yes.
The traveling vlog. What is it all about?
So basically what we do is we travel around Africa to show the beautiful side of the continent. Mm-hmm. Because as we know, Africa has a bad name, you know, because the Western media mostly shows the negative things, diseases, poverty, you know, just bad things. So we're showing that there's more to Africa. We're not perfect, mm-hmm. but there's more to Africa. We also have beautiful places. You know, Africa is a place to be, it's a place to live. Yeah, we're just showing what is not being shown.
And before we get really the details of what exactly is at Miss Trudy's vlog, YouTube followers, you have tons in great numbers. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
What does it take to get people persuaded to actually hit that button and get you into that place where now you have all those followers or subscribers, as we are calling it on YouTube?
Well, it's a journey. I've been doing this for 3 years. Now I'm starting my fourth year. So, you know, it's taken time. It doesn't happen overnight. And I just take consistency, creativity.
And finally, lunch is served.
Where did you grow up?
This
Who are you
is our first.
Where do you come from? Who are you behind the camera?
Well, Miss Trudy, I'm just a simple girl, you know. I'm born and raised in Nairobi. I'm just Nairobian, like 100%.
Where did you grow up in Nairobi?
In Kenyatta. My dad used to work in Kenyatta Hospital. So I grew up in Kenyatta with doctors and nurses.
Yeah.
I schooled in Milimani Primary. I just used to play a lot. You know, we didn't have phones. We just used to go out and play. Blada, Brikicho. Mm-hmm. You know, these games.
Kati.
You know Kati?
Of course I do. We did it.
Yeah, man, that was my favorite when I was a kid.
Oh yeah?
Pili akurusha pole kwenye twaji. Where someone is on the... Oh, that's Kati.
That's Kati.
That's Kati. I was confusing it with Vlada.
How was adolescence for you in high school? Anything that stood out that was really the worst.
Okay, one of the worst moments in my life was my adolescence. One of the reasons is because I lost my mom when I was 16. So it was so hard, like, because you're moving from a girl, now you see your body's changing, you're starting your periods.
Yeah.
Can I talk about that?
Of course you can.
So you puberty see, when you're 16, yeah, you puberty, now you're having pimples, and you're like, oh my God, I had pimples.
Why
I had pimples?
Nobody can tell, actually.
I used to cry, and I'd be like, okay, God, I'm sorry, just take those pimples away.
I can't be this ugly.
Oh my, you used to be bad, I used to cry. Thank God it's over, you know, at least the face is not that bad.
And eventually they go away. I think with patience, with time, they all go away.
Yeah. So yeah, that was a crazy time of my life.
Take me back to how you started until this point.
Well, I was fired from my former job.
Oh.
Yeah. I used to do promotions in a supermarket. You know promotions?
Oh yeah, I do.
Yeah,
merchandise promotion, right?
Okay. Yeah. Oh. Where you stand in the supermarket the whole day from like 8 till 6, you know, and you try to convince customers who walk in, oh, please buy this.
You know. If you take this, you get one extra.
Ah, yeah.
And the size really doesn't matter.
Have you done it before?
I haven't, but I have actually seen it happen.
Because you're talking like you have experience.
I have come close to those who do it.
Okay.
And it's a lovely job, really.
Well, depends on how you look at it.
Right?
For me, at first it was okay, but then after some time I started getting tired because you get like 30 minutes lunch break, you get paid 500 a day, and you have to stand from morning till evening. So it got to a time where my legs started swelling.
Are you allowed to pee? To go pee?
Yeah, but you better be fast. Hurry up and come back.
Or we are deducting your salary for real?
You won't lose customers because
of
you.
Oh my God.
Keep your phone away. Don't lean on anything. Stand from morning till evening.
What is the difference between you at that point and the statues in the supermarket?
Thank you so much. That's the thing. There's no difference.
Sorry. So here you get fired.
Oh yeah. I get fired and I got devastated.
Which year is this?
Like 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
I got devastated.
2017-18.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I thought my life was over because I was a promoter. I was expecting to be promoted to a merchandiser. These are guys who come just arrange stuff in the supermarket and go, so they don't have to stand the whole day. So when I thought I was going to be promoted, I got fired and it shocked me. I cried. I thought my life was over, you know.
Yeah, like everyone who loses a job. It's that time when you have planned for everything and then all of a sudden comes to an end.
Yeah.
Then you wake up another day. How many days did it take you down?
Man, about 3 months I was depressed, you know. I was crying in my room. I was like, God, what did I do wrong, you know. So for like 3 months I was just crying, depressed in my room. I thought my life was over. And that is the moment I discovered YouTube.
How did you discover it? Did you come across an inspiring video?
I just used to watch a lot of music, you know. And then one day I came across a vlog, but it was from a white person. And I was like, okay, what's this? Then I discovered, you know, Kenyans doing it. I was like, what? You mean there are black people doing it? What is this thing? So I decided to explore. And it intrigued me and I decided to start creating content also.
At some point, actually, people look at this and maybe they are fascinated as well. But they're thinking, wait, how am I going to get a camera? Are people going to subscribe, actually? With all the other, you know, YouTube channels, how is somebody going to get interested in my own? Did you have these questions? How did you go about it?
Oh, yeah, for sure. So when I started, I didn't have enough money. I couldn't even buy myself a camera. Leave alone a camera, like a good phone. Like I had such a bad phone, you know. Like phones that you're like, okay, what's going on? Like, my phone was just so bad.
Yeah.
But I did not let that hold me back. I just started with what I had. Yeah, because if you wait to get perfect, you'll never start. So I just started with my very poor phone camera. And I kept doing it and I kept improving, you know. 1 year later, I got a better phone, which was still very cheap, you know.
But it was better. Better is the word there.
Yeah.
Your first destination, first subscription, where did you decide to go to and how did you go about it?
Okay, so first I was just traveling within Kenya. But the first time I left Kenya, I went to Uganda. That time, I didn't have enough cash and my brother said he was going for a business trip to Uganda and he was like, oh, I could pay. And I was like, oh my God, thank you. So just like that, my brother paid for my first trip outside Kenya to Uganda. Oh, so basically we introduce Africa to the world, to the diaspora. Show people what they should expect when they come to Africa. Show them beautiful places. Mm-hmm. And the
beautiful
culture.
Beautiful spots and the culture.
Yeah.
Basically promoting tourism. You come and partake what we have, which is really beautiful. Mm-hmm. And I think it's amazing. You ever passionate about traveling before you began this? Or this was just a situation that moved you into looking out for something that you could do in the moment?
Well, traveling is something that used to cross my mind. Though I didn't think I would actually pursue it. My relatives used to travel and they used to be like, oh, must be nice, you know, must be nice. And there's a time, someone invited me to Netherlands. A Kenyan living in Netherlands who was married to a white man. And she told me, oh, Trudy, come over. I'll host you. Your food is sorted, your accommodation, transportation, we'll take you around. All you have to do is pay for your flight ticket. And I was like, oh my gosh, thank you, Jesus. I was so happy. Then I went, I Googled and I saw the price. It was 90,000.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, oh my God. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't even make that in a month. Even in a year, I'll have to work so hard to make 90K.
Extra hard.
So my heart just sank. And I just told God, God, I don't know. I guess you do. There's nothing impossible. So I don't know how I will ever afford to travel. But I know you make ways where there are no ways, and just make it happen for me.
And surely he has.
He did, man.
Turning this passion into portfolio, because now we have young people looking out for the current and modern platforms of making money out of all these experiences that exist online. What does it take, really, now to turn this vlogging from your phone into numbers and then these numbers into something that actually looks like money? Because you have to get money out of somebody's pocket. What does it take?
I think it takes, first, it's hard work, you know. Mm-hmm. Some people, they want to make it, but they don't know that there is hard work behind everything, you know. So first of all, I think it's hard work. Second, you have to be consistent. Like, you can't be posting once a month. Like, you really have to be consistent at what you do. Number three, you have to be very creative. Mm-hmm. You just can't put everything together and just put it out there, you know. You have to know what people want and give it to them, mm-hmm. you know. You have to know what will make people click, you know.
Right, right.
So, meaning you need to study your audience and give them what they want.
What was your most watched video? What was it about?
My most watched video... Mm-hmm. is a video where I proposed to my boyfriend.
So you're the best boyfriend in the whole world, and I really want to be with you the rest of my life, so...
Wow!
Yeah, but it was a prank, but proposed to him.
Would you in real life?
No way. How do you propose to a guy?
Well, you love him and you've been dating for some time and he's not asking you
Let him ask. Never. Me? Propose? How?
I mean, marriage is for two people.
Would you do that? Would you propose to a guy?
Haven't thought about it before this moment.
Me, I will never do that.
Right.
Yeah.
And people loved it because it was a social abnormal situation in the society. You're going to touch a bit on your current relationship. It's one beautiful thing for us who watch from afar. But for now, let's take a quick break. We are coming back and Miss Trudy is going to tell us just how amazing it is to go across the borders to find love. Don't go too far.